Good afternoon, students. Today our topic is integrity constraints. Okay, integrity constraints in database management system. Integrity constraints are a set of rules. It is used to maintain the quality of information. Okay, it is a set of rules which using these rules we can maintain a quality of information in our database. Okay, and integrity constraints ensure that the data is insertion or updation and other processes have to be performed in such a way that data integrity is affected. Means integrity constraints is used to guard against accidental damage to the database. With using these integrity constraints, we can protect our database safely. Okay. And these integrity constraints are divided into four types. The first one is domain integrity constraints, entity integrity constraints, referential integrity constraints, and key integrity constraints. These integrity constraints are divided into these four types. We'll see one by one. Okay. And the first one, domain integrity constraints. First one, domain integrity constraints. Domain integrity constraints can be defined as the definition of a valid set of values for an attribute, for an particular attribute. It can be defined as the definition of a valid set of values for an attribute. And also the data type of domain includes a string, character, integer, time, date, currency, etc. Okay. The value of attribute must be available in the corresponding domain. Okay. And we'll see example how that domain constraint we can define. How can we see the domain constraints? As per example, we'll discuss. Okay, and see here. The assume this table name is like some student information table. Okay, this particular table or relation in our relational database management system we can call a relation. Okay. In this relation contains some list of attributes like ID and name, semester, age. Okay. And where these columns are, these attribute data types are ID, we can take as a integer data type, and name we can take a varchar data type, semester we can take character data type, and age we can take integer data type. Okay. Then when we are inserting values in this particular table, the student information table, okay, we need to specify that particular the attribute as the data type is, if integer, we need to mention integer only, and character, we need to insert character only. For example, if you are inserting instead of integer character, that is not allowed because that particular column or that particular attribute is integer data type. Okay. See here in this example, age is the integer data type. If you are inserting some character, it is not allowed because age is an integer attribute. Okay. And this type of one we can call domain integrity constraints. Okay. And whereas coming to next one, entity integrity constraints. Okay. The entity integrity constraints states that primary key value can't be null. The entity integrity constraint is this is because the primary key value is used to identify individual rows in a relation, and if the primary key has a null value, then we can't identify those rows uniquely. Means with using the primary key value, it is used to identify individual rows in a particular relation. Okay. If the primary key has a null, then we can't identify those rows. Okay. That's why the integrity constraint states the primary key value can't be null. Okay. And here a table can contain null value other than primary key field. The table can contain null value other than primary key field. We'll see an example. I'm sorry. Here and here that employee table having the fields or attributes, we can call employee name and employee employee ID, employee name, salary. Okay, And here we are taking employee ID as a primary key. Okay. And primary key means if employee ID is primary key means it is not allowed, a null value or empty values or duplicate values. Okay. And here, when we are inserting values, that employee ID should be, we need to enter compulsory that unique value. Otherwise, if that if it is null value, it is not allowed as a primary key, can't contain null value. It says that when we are creating this, when we are inserting this particular records, then if you are leaving that primary key as a null value, means it is not allowed as primary key, cannot contain a null value. Okay, this type of one we can call it, in this example, that is a primary key is null value, but entity integrity constraint states that primary key value can be, primary key value cannot be null value. Okay, and that is about entity integrity constraint. And means it, we can say it is a set of rules, that's it. Okay, we are means for a primary key can't be null, for providing proper data type, and for all these purpose. Okay, next, referential integrity constraints. The referential integrity constraints means that referential integrity constraints specified between two tables. That referential integrity constraints we are specifying between two tables. In referential integrity constraints, if a foreign key in table one, okay, refers to the primary key of table 2, then every value of foreign key in table 1, every value of foreign key in table 1 must be null, or that will be available in table 2, must be null, or that that value will be available in table 2, this table. Okay, and we'll see example. And here the example, the table one contains employee name, age, date of door number, and table one contains door number and location. Here the door number is a primary key, and here we are taking the door number as a foreign key. Then the relationship is established between these two, referential integrity constraint. Okay, here let me erase. And in this example, okay, the table, that common field door number from table 1 and table 2, here door number is a primary key in table 2, and door number here table 1, that is a foreign key. Okay, here that if the foreign key in table 1 refers to the primary key of table 2, then every value of foreign key in table 1 must be null or available in table 2. For example, here the door number 11, that will be available in table 2, okay, that will be inserted. And next one, 24, okay, that will be available in table 2, that also will be inserted. And next, third one, 18, that 18 is not available in table 2. It is not allowed as door number 18, not defined as a primary key in table 2. Okay, close error like this. And here that door number 18 is not defined as a primary key in table 2, and in table 1 door number is a foreign key defined. That's why the here we discussed then every value of foreign key in table 1 must be null or available in table 2. Okay, this is about referential integrity constraints. And next one, that is key integrity constraints. The last one, that is a key integrity constraint. Okay, the keys are the entity set that is used to identify an entity within its entity set uniquely. The keys are the entity set, okay, that is used to identify the entity within its entity set uniquely, like primary key. Okay, and an entity set can have multiple keys. An entity set can have multiple keys, but out of which one key will be the primary key. Okay, the table or relation have multiple keys, but out of that keys, one key we are taking as a primary key. A primary key can contain a unique and null value in the relational database management system. Okay, here in this example, that key constraints here, see there is a some list of attributes in student table: ID, name, semester, and age. When we are inserting these information, that ID is a primary key that should be a unique. Okay, here we are inserting 1000. And 101 means that the value not duplicate value, but it should be a unique. Okay, and here 1000 101 102 103, and whereas coming to next fourth record, the fifth record, that is again 102, means it is a duplicate value. Then in the this key constraint, that is not allowed because all row must be unique. Why? Because that ID is a primary key attribute. Okay, and this is what key constraints. Okay, these are the four different types of constraints, integrity constraints. Okay, each one having separate importance, like domain constraints. Okay, and that is related to particular data type. Okay, and entity integrity constraints, and that is should be null value, means primary key value can't be null. And referential integrity constraints means it is specified between two tables. Next, key integrity constraints, it is mean by like keys are the entity set that is used to identify an entity within an entity set uniquely. Okay, and